rise of people who need that assistance who are even employed.
Melbourne's vacancy rate fell in March to 1.38%, the biggest decline of any city in Australia.
Renters are getting increasingly desperate.
Kathleen O'Connor, 7 News.
The cleanup is underway in the aftermath of tropical cyclone Ilsa. Ships returned to Port Hedland today with repairs expected to take months. The system has been downgraded and roads reopened. Inland stations were hit hardest by the severe weather system.
Sending a message of mail to the road racing community. Yeah, just very grateful that didn't come to us. And sad for them out there.
The tiny outpost of Pardoo lay directly in the path of the Category 5 cyclone. Doctors are calling for an overhaul of the guidelines for screening cardiovascular disease.
Scientists
say the current system fails to detect hundreds of thousands of patients at risk of a sudden heart attack, or panic explains.
Cricket legend Shane Warne's tragic and unexpected death at the age of 52 inspired thousands of Australians to check their hearts, the so-called Warne effect. Coronary heart disease claims 50 lives every day. But doctors say sudden heart attacks are largely preventable with the right testing. Some of our leading heart disease institutes are calling for the widespread adoption of a test known as a CT scan calcium score. It measures the amount of calcium in the walls of the arteries. Some people may score zero, meaning they have no calcified plaque, despite having high blood pressure and cholesterol. But others without those usual risk factors may already have a dangerous buildup. The test is not covered by Medicare and costs on average around $200. But the Heart Foundation, which publishes the screening guidelines, is pushing back, saying while coronary calcium scoring has a role to play, it needs to be used appropriately. But it's unlikely to stop growing calls for more widespread calcium scoring to catch those most at risk despite showing no symptoms.
There's bad news for Australia's Olympic heroes. The plan to ban partying in the Paris Olympic Village next on 7 News. Also ahead, protests intensify in the French capital over a controversial call on the retirement age. An unexpected shock for a US presidential candidate, and Australia plays host to a global cake contest.
The Bali bombings, that site will live with me forever. The incredible acts of courage.
I believe free and away from the flames.
That helped so many survive the worst of attacks.
I just wanted to stay with her and hold her.
A special code one, Sunday on 7 and 7 Plus.
An impulse. An electrical force that drives us to do what we feel. The heart pulse. With just emotion. As humans, we contain this impulse. But nothing takes us further than the impulse bursting inside. The impulse of a new age. Cooper Born, full electric.
The actual waste make month is the 2-point.
One piece, single-sided, with a tapped pillow top made out of foam.
Yes, Mr. Harvey, they should be 50% off. The best way.
Two-piece, double-sided, removable pillow top with thousands of microcoils and a 5-year comfort promise.
See, Mr. Harvey, we make them, you know.
The Bellissimo mattress made like no other mattress. Making mattresses, nobody makes a better mattress. Nobody.
My speed boost from Super Loop lets these guys get extra internet juice. So, mom can be teasing while dad's streaming. Belle can look for book recommends while Bo is sliding into someone's DMs.
That's not what emojis are for.
Refresh your internet with my speed boost from Super Loop.
The next Scarlet Easter clearance. In store and online now.
It can stalk, threaten, or stare. It can hurl abuse at you. Or quietly comment on your sexuality. It can brush up against you, deliberately, or grab you with force. It can follow you anywhere. It targets workers based on their gender or identity. But it can be stopped. Gendered violence comes in many forms. All are OHS issues. All are unacceptable.
Athletes are hitting back at the Australian Olympic Committee over plans to kick them out of the Paris Olympic Village as soon as their events are over. Officials want to put a stop to partying to allow the rest of the team to focus.
When our Olympians are going for
gold,
some of their best support comes from the Olympics Village. In celebration, commiseration, teammates together. But in Paris 2024, athletes will have to leave within 2 or 3 days of finishing their events, which for some is day one.
It's just being able to give everyone that fair go and their opportunity in the game.
In Tokyo, the IOC ordered a quick departure because of COVID, which officials say worked well.
Having the pressure on the village down, the medical team was able to draw the athletes who were still competing.
The Olympians argue by clearing out the village.
Essentially, the robbing Olympic athletes of that full Olympic experience.
But the AOC insists it's not about party pooping or saving money.
It's 48 hours, so it's a little bit of time. They're having a little party after the finish of the competition.
Remaining in the village isn't about partying. It's about supporting your teammates, supporting other Aussies, cheering in the crowd, wearing the green and gold, and hopefully boosting them to a medal themselves.
Officials say athletes wanting to return for the closing ceremony will be accommodated.
The French government has passed controversial laws to raise the pension age, with mass protests set to continue. It is a major win for embattling President Emmanuel Macron, but he continues to face pushback across the country.
Another night of chaos in Paris. After a day that brought the battle over French pensions to a head in the next Olympic City. France's Constitutional Council, under heavy security, ruling the push to raise the retirement age from 62 to 64 without a parliamentary vote is lawful.
Commissioner, I can see an already had the need to stop the fall, because of course we remain opposed to the fall.
It's disgusting, this woman says. The violence will get worse.
What can I say? I'm shocked. We're living in a democracy,
Emmanuel Macron, preparing for the law to be enacted, is already trying to move on, touring reconstruction works at Notre Dame Cathedral. The rebuild could be a crowning achievement of his presidency, likely overshadowed by the unrest that's plagued France for weeks, even years.
For me, for my kids, I don't want that for France, but I think Macron just plays this game.
7 years.
A Russian missile strike has killed at least 8 people in the eastern Ukrainian city of Slavyansk. A toddler is among the dead. Another 21 people were injured. The missile struck the top of a 5-story residential building. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky has been another act of Russian terrorism. There's been a security scare for the man most likely to challenge Donald Trump as Republican nominee for president. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis had a speech interrupted when he stormed the stage. DeSantis was unharmed and the two women escorted out of the building. Master bakers from around the world have arrived in Australia to compete for the International Cake Show. One local is on track to take the title with his life-size baked replica of one of Hollywood's most famous carts.
A scene straight from a movie, except this version is edible. She travelled in from Adelaide, her local cold supermarket collected the corn set for 9 months for her to be able to make.
That's a more eatable. That looks a lot better.
Taking over the RNA showgrounds until Sunday afternoon, more than 10,000 people are expected. We've got Battle of the Sugar Giants, which is what's behind me. International Cake Royalty also joining the mix.
This is the Cake Off, which the 2 days, 2 whole days, we've got teams, a team from Australia, and we've got a team from the rest of the world.
Battling it out, grabbing rides.
We're doing Cake Off Rattle, so we're doing Gingerbread House, with Paul Towers.
It took 9 months to build it. Which hit the wings and stormed the stage. DeSantis was unharmed and the two women escorted out of the building. Master bakers from around the world have arrived in Australia to compete in the
International Cake Show. Here you go, Alex, just for you to eat it all.
One local
go on, go
is
and eat
on track
it all.
To take the title with his life-size baked replica of one of Hollywood's most famous cars. A scene straight from a movie, except this version is edible.
She travelled here from Adelaide. Her local Coles supermarket collected the corn silk for 9 months for her to be able to make that exhibit.
A life-sized cake replica of the Lion King, one of
go on, Alex, go and eat it all.
The International Cake Show.
People from all over Australia and all over the world, 27 different countries have come here to compete.
Taking over the RNA showgrounds until Sunday afternoon, more than 10,000 people are expected through the doors.
We've got Battle of the Sugar Giants, which is what's behind me.
International Cake Royalty also joining the mix.
Now this is the Cake Off, which for 2 days, 2 whole days, we've got teams, a team from Australia, and we've got a team from
Australia. Go on, Alex, go and eat it all.
It out for bragging rights.
Got all your name on it.
So we're doing Gingerbread House, Big Tall Towers.
It took 9 months to build this completely edible, life-sized bumblebee car, and on Sunday afternoon at 3 o'clock, it will be cut into pieces.